What's up? Today I'm going to discuss how to troubleshoot computer system network.
Troubleshooting computer system network. Causes of network trouble. If a computer is unable to connect to a network or see other computers on the network, it may be necessary to troubleshoot the networks. A network may be network because of any of the reasons below. First, network card not properly connected. Second, bad network card drivers as software settings. Third, firewall preventing computers from seeing each other. Fourth, connection related issues. And five, bad network hardware. Verify connections or ledges. Verify the network cable is properly connected to the back of the computer. In addition, in checking the connection of the network cable, ensure that the ledges on the computer network are properly eliminated. For example, a network card with a solid green dot or light usually indicates that the card is either connected or receiving a signal. If, however, the card does not have any lights or has orange or red lights, it is possible that either the card is bad, the card is not connected properly, or that the card is not receiving a signal from the network. If you are on a small or local network and have the capability of checking a hub or switch, verify that the cables are properly connected and the hub or switch has power. Adapter resources. Ensure that if this is a new network card being installed into the computer, that the card resources are properly set and not conflicting with any hardware in the computer. Adapter functionality. Verify that the network card is capable of detecting or seeing itself by using the ping command. Windows or MS-DOS users ping the computer from MS-DOS prompt. Unix or Linux variant users ping to the computer from the shell. To ping the card or the local host, type either ping 127.0.0.01 or ping localhost. This should show a listing of replies from the network card. If receive an error or if the transmission failed, it is likely that either the card is not physically installed into the computer correctly or that the card is bad. Protocol. Verify the correct protocols are installed on the computer. Most networks today will utilize TCP or IP but may also utilize or require IPX and SPX and the NetView. When the TCP or IP protocol is installed, unless a DNS server or the other computer assigns the IPX address, the user must specify an IP address as well as subnet mask. To do this, follow the instruction below. First, click Start Settings Control Panel. Second, double-click the network icon. Third, within the configuration, double-click the TCP or IP protocol icon. Note, do not click on the PPP or dial-up adapter. Click on the network card adapter. Fourth, in the TCP or IP properties, click the IP address tab. Fifth, select the option to specify an IP address. Sixth, the IP address and subnet mask address. An example of such an address could be IP address 102.55.92.1, subnet mask 255.255.255.192. 7. When specifying these values, the computers on the network must all have the same subnet mask and have a different IP address. For example, when using the above values on one computer, you would want to use an IP address of 102.55.92.2 on another computer and then specify the same subnet mask. Firewall. If your computer network utilizes a firewall, ensure that all ports required are open. If possible, close the firewall software program or disconnect the computer from the firewall to ensure it is not causing the problem. Additional time. In some cases, it may take a computer some additional time to detect or see the network. If after booting the computer you are unable to see the network, give the computer 2 to 3 minutes to detect the network. Windows users may also want to try pressing the F5 or refresh given in network neighborhood to refresh the network connections and possibly detect the network. Additional troubleshooting. If they're following verifying the above recommendations, you are still unable to connect or see the network. Attempt one or more of the below recommendations. If you have installed or are using TCP or ICP as your protocol, you can ping another computer's IP address to verify if the computer is able to send and receive data. To do this, Windows or MS-DOS users must be at the prompt in Linux. Or Unix variant users must open or be at the shell. Once at the prompt, assuming that the address of the computer you reach to ping is 102.55.92, you would type ping 155.92.2. If you receive a response back from this address and it is a different computer, this demonstrates that the computer is communicating over the network. If you're still unable to connect or see the network, it is possible that other issues may be represented. Another method that determines network issues is to use the traceroute command if you have a MS-DOS or Windows user, or the traceroute command. If you're a Linux or Unix variant user, to use this command, you must be at the command prompt or shell or traceroute 102.55.92.2. This should begin listing the hops between the computer and network devices. When the connection fails, determine what device is causing the issue by reviewing the traceroute listing.